Hi guys, today I just wanted to talk about my dermatologist appointment that I went to for Angular Cheilitis, which is a red sore-like cracking you get on the corner of your lips. I kind of feel obliged to make this video because I've had it for the last 6 years, which affected me quite a lot when I was a teenager, but eventually after years of research and doctor's appointments and everything, and eventually after seeing a dermatologist, it's cleared up in the last month or so. So I'm pretty happy about it, actually. I just wanted to share all the knowledge I've gradually built up about it. And don't really think you should have to pay for it, like a few websites make you do, or pay for a dermatologist, which was very, very expensive because it was on Harley Street in London. I'm going to split the video into two sections. I'm going to talk about what angular cheilitis is and about the cause of it, you know, how to avoid it, and then obviously how to cure it. Okay, to start off with, it is a fungal infection crossed with some kind of mild eczema. It's the fungal infection that's making your lips crack, but the eczema also makes it worse by drying it out. It's found on the corners of your lips because fungal infections like warm, moist places, which don't get any sunlight, and obviously with your lips making shadow on the corner of your lips, having saliva there and everything, it's the perfect place for a fungal infection. One of the big problems that cause it as well is drooling in your sleep, which I do, because it's warm and moist throughout the whole of the night, which is perfect for a fungus to live in. It's also very linked in with eczema, so if you have even the mildest eczema like I do, then you're more likely to get it. One of the stages of curing the angular cheilitis is to do with treating the dry eczema like skin. So if your doctor prescribed hydrocortisone, then he's probably right, kind of half right. One thing not to do is use foundation or anything on it, because it naturally dries out the skin, so it's quite bad for the infection as well, which I found out. It could also be vitamin 2, B6 or B12 deficiency in your bloodstream, which you know, quite a few doctors and most internet forums agree on. So you can easily fix that with some multivitamins, but it's worth getting checked out if your condition is quite bad. Licking your lips is also quite bad, which a lot of forums tell you not to do, because again it gets the corners of your lips more moist, which we don't want. If you've got dry lips, use Vaseline, because it will keep them nice and hydrated without affecting anything. If you find your actual lips get dry, as well as having an angular cheilitis, then instead of licking them, use Vaseline. I found out when my angular cheilitis healed, so did my dry lips. But if they don't, then I guess go see a doctor or something. Those are the causes of it. Moving on to the cure, I'm just saying, I'm not a doctor, so you might want to get all of this checked out by one just before doing it. So, I mean, you should be perfectly safe, but I don't want to be responsible just in case anything happens. It's just me telling you what I did. But yeah, sorry to be dire. When I went to the dermatologist, after him swabbing my lips, he recommended two creams. One of them was this one, which is Fusibet cream. Specifically, it says fusidic acid and betamethasone. What that pretty much means is it's an antifungal cream mixed with a steroid cream. And how that helps you is the antifungal bit deals with the infection, while the steroid gradually repairs the redness in the skin and the eczema and all that. Now, you use it by putting it on sparingly on the affected bits twice a day, and you do that for about 2 weeks until you can see that the cracks have hopefully disappeared. You can't use it for much longer than 2 weeks though, because the steroid in it, the betamethasone, if you use it too much, it can gradually damage your skin and burn it. And like, if you Google like steroid burns on, you see a lot of like bad images about it, so I wouldn't use it too much. You can't use it longer than 2 weeks, and especially that steroid is quite powerful. So while using the cream, if your lips get drier, then you can use Vaseline. What not to do while using it either is pick bits of skin, because that will damage the process, or if you use any foundation on it, that plays around with the ingredients of the cream as well. So don't do that. Hopefully, after a week or two, the cracks will be gone, which means the fungal infection is gone. And if you're lucky, the redness will almost be gone too. If it hasn't, I guess there are some more underlying problems, and you could have an allergy that causes the infection. Apparently, it can be linked to certain ingredients in toothpaste. So if it really hasn't shown any signs of clearing up, you might need to get an allergy test from a doctor somewhere. Anyway, because I had it for longer, the red was still there quite a bit. So I needed some form of steroids to get rid of it still. But since you can't use any more steroids just in case you damage your skin, I got recommended this, which is called Protopic 0.1% Ointment. This is pretty much what doctors prescribe heavy eczema sufferers, because you can use it like a steroid to heal the skin without having to worry about burning your skin or anything. The only reason it's not used more is it's really expensive. Like that tiny one here is £30 on its own. So it's a bit pricey, but it's worth it to get rid of the Angular Cheilitis, I think. I use that once a day, sparingly on the red bits, and it's almost disappeared in the last month or so. You can still see it a bit, but it's getting more and more faded every week because it's healing still. And I guess you just stop using it when it's gone. And that's it, I guess. What you should try to do in the process of it is make sure you sleep on your back so you don't draw onto your lips. Keep hydrated with plenty of water. Keep your lips hydrated with Vaseline, don't lick them. Keep them clean and shower every day. Use multivitamin tablets just to make sure it's not a deficiency. And that's pretty much it, actually. I'll show you the cream again, so you know what they are and the specific. I'm going to write these specifics of them in the description. Make sure you see a doctor just on the off chance you're allergic to any of these creams. They work perfectly for me, but you know it's all different to people, so it could go wrong. Comment to let me know how you've done. Hopefully I've saved you an expensive trip to a dermatologist, and you'll be able to get on with your lives with normal lips. Thanks for listening, and good luck.